Hey guys, Forrest here. I'm about to show you some smokes and Molotovs to help you defend a city on overpass. Some of you might have seen these before. It might be super easy, but there are still people out there who don't know these smokes, and I thought it might be helpful to show them. So first off, we're gonna start with a smoke from CD spawn, a smoke you want to throw at the beginning of the round to help the players over at B to defend it easier against rushes. So what you want to do is line up with this thing right here. Line it up, you straight down, look at it, and then you line your crosshair at the edge of this pole right here. And all you gotta do is mouse one, and then you walk until the crosshair reaches that ledge. And that should seal the deal with that smoke. And what it's gonna do, it's gonna help players defending B, and it also might scare off some rushes if T's are trying to push through. So you should have an advantage once they come through the smoke. Super simple, but super important as well. Could be super important. The other thing I'm gonna show you as well, this is also concerns the B site, is a Molotov that is gonna cut this path off in the beginning as well. So both this smoke and this Molotov is gonna prevent fast B pushes and B takes towards this area right here. Makes it so much easier for CT to take some control in the beginning. So all you gotta do is line up with this door right here. It's not super important. You just stand somewhere here, line up your Molotov here at the second balcony and throw it. You could probably tweak it a bit better, but you get the idea. Playing on A though, there's a different story. There's a lot of stuff you can do here as CT, but I think the most important part is to try and get some mind games going with the terrorists. What I'm thinking is a good idea, at least, is to smoke middle, of course. We're gonna get to this, but this will scare them a bit. They don't know if you jump up over here. They can't see you. And what it will force them to do is use a bit more nades to clear this area. They will start to use flashes to clear this. So it's not going to be a free pathway for them to just rush and take it over. Because if you don't smoke, obviously the T is going to stand here with an AWP or AK. Whatever, and just stand here and peek, and they will know for sure that you're not up there. So that's also a small trick, or not a trick, it's a smoke that's very useful for CT. And at the same time, you also could do mind games with not smoking this off and standing in positions with an AWP, forcing them to use more nades to take this area over. You could also, when not smoking, do an AWP peek here. I don't recommend you to do it the first round or the second. You have a feeling when you want to do it, but always mix up the game here. Smoke, don't smoke. Keep them guessing what you're gonna do. Sometimes you won't go aggressive here. Sometimes you will go aggressive. Sometimes you won't smoke and go aggressive. Sometimes you won't smoke and don't go aggressive. You just gotta mix it up a lot, and that's gonna make it harder for T as well to play around this area. It's at least gonna take them longer to take it over, and it's gonna buy you more time of defending the site. So as I stated before, smoke, don't smoke, keep them guessing, go aggressive, don't, etc. But also it comes down to this door play right here. You don't want to make it obvious that when you're down here underground, when you smoke, you're 100% here. So if you throw a smoke, and every time you throw smoke down here, that's a bad thing, right? So sometimes, same thing as middle. Smoke, don't smoke, do a bit random stuff, keep them guessing. Sometimes you're gonna stay here when you smoke, sometimes you're gonna smoke and don't stay here. All about keeping them guessing. Gonna take them a bit longer to clear this as well. They might use Molotovs and stuff, they might use an extra flash or two just to clear this area. Also, when some rounds, what you could do is, I don't have another player here with me, but I think what you want to do is you boost here, and what you can do then is see towards the sewers. So let's say when your friend doesn't have a Molotov for the sewer right here, go and do this boost. So the T's might think it's safe to go out there, but boom, it's not. So that's also a small little trick I wish I could show you, but is you technically boost here, and then you can see over this window. Also small little trick. It's a very useful boost, so use it wisely. And that's pretty much it. A defense is a bit just keeping the enemies guessing where you might be or not be. Same with long, sometimes you gotta stack long, sometimes you have one guy peeking long. And I'm gonna show you guys another position, which is a bit risky to do. It's also late round when you're falling back from long or mid SCT. What you could do is hide in this corner. I know people do Molotov this place, but usually tease smoke here, around here, somewhere, so they can move forward and start lining up nades, so they won't be able to Molotov this spot. But when you have a good feeling, you could stand in this corner. If you see a small line going here, what you want to do is line it up with your crosser, like this. So you see, that's that, and my crosser is in line with that one. And then you press mouse 2, that's all you gotta do. And when you feel that the timing is right, all you gotta do is release, and boom, you go. What is it gotta do? It's, they're not gonna see the flash coming. It's literally impossible for enemies to spot it. And what it's, I mean, it's a really cool surprise move. So even if you hear a Molotov coming, you're gonna stand with a flash ready anyways. So when you hear a Molotov, boom, go flash, just play cool, and then go out and kill them. Either kill them or run away. But it's a risky position, but it might be worth a try sometimes. Ocean's too shallow, the storm's too weak. It's deep inside us, you see. We never follow. Instead we seek nothing.